Standard separation of responsibilities between a 1C developer and a user is when the developer creates metadata objects like the sales document and the user fills them up with data items like this one. But sometimes developers need data items that are under their full control. We already looked at the Enumeration Metadata class that is pre-filled by a developer and cannot be edited by a user, like for example this PaymentMethod enumeration. Let's take a look at another example of predefined data in 1C Enterprise. An important feature of the enumerations is that developers can afford using their values in the source code like this. It's safe because users can never change or delete the existing value. But there are cases when we want some items to be predefined but allow users to add the new ones. Let's take a look, for example, at one of the issues that I, as an imaginary store owner, need to handle on a daily basis. As you might remember from episode 5, I keep track of all agreements between my company and suppliers. Besides that, I need to sign and email actual PDF agreements. So one day I thought, wouldn't it be easier if I stored the PDFs right in the application and sent them directly from it? This is the task we are going to need predefined items for, so let me show you why. First things first, we need to store the PDF file somewhere in the agreements catalog. In 1C Enterprise, we use value storage for that. How to save the file to the value storage and restore it back to the disk, it's a topic for 1C senior developer level. For now, let's just suppose the file is already there by some miracle. Now we need to store the company's email somewhere, right? It has to live in the company's catalog, but it cannot be just an attribute like this. First of all, there might be many different email addresses. And second of all, as soon as we started storing contact information, we can as well save other types of contacts, phone numbers, Skype names, and what have you. In other words, we need some kind of a list. This is what we could use a tabular section for. So I'm creating a new one and call it contacts. What attributes do we need in here? First, the contact itself, so I'm creating it and giving it a little bit more room. Now I need a way of telling one type of contact from another, so I'm creating a contact type attribute. Can I leave it like this, having the string type? No, I don't think so. I will need to check the contact type value from the code, but I cannot know what creative ways of naming contact types my users will come up with. So no string for me this time. Should I use an enumeration? Well, this could work, except I would have to add a new enumeration value every time a new contact type appears. The bad news is that my buddy Kim and others who use my app won't be able to do it by themselves and will start asking me to help them again. So I need some hybrid between an enumeration and a catalog. These special catalog items are called the predefined data. More specifically, I need a catalog where some elements behave as the enumeration values. They should live in the application and go along with it wherever it goes. They should be fixed in a sense that users cannot delete or edit them, so that I could use them in the source code. Let me clean this up and show you where they live. I'm going to create the contact types catalog. And the other tab is where you can find the predefined data button. This is where we can create these fixed items that can be used in the source code. So I'm going to create my email element here. Let's add the catalog to the list subsystem and check out what it looks like in the application. As you can see, the platform already shows this email element, even though I just created a catalog and never added any data to it. What actually happened here is the platform saw the predefined item in the metadata object and created a catalog item, pointing to it with this predefined data name standard attribute. Let's create the item form for this catalog and take a closer look. I'm creating a new form, selecting these two standard attributes, and this is what it looks like in the application. This is just as normal catalog item as any other, but it is created by the platform automatically, marked as predefined and bound to the predefined item name by this attribute value. I actually can easily break the link between the data item and the predefined item by just emptying this field. Then I can add another item and bind it to the same predefined item. And here we go. Note that the platform marks the predefined item with these icons, so a user can tell the predefined ones from the regular ones. Of course, we usually do not show these standard attributes to users, so they cannot break those links. We also do not allow them to delete predefined items by setting up the access rights. This is out of scope for this episode, but let me just show you where it lives real quick. I'm going to the roles, creating a new one, selecting our catalog, and here are the access rights to predefined items. These should be switched off for all normal users' roles. Okay, let's see how we can use the predefined item in the code. Still remember the task? We wanted to send agreements by email from the app. So I'm going here to the agreements catalog, creating the item form and adding a new comment to it. We need to work with the data, so I'm using this code template down here. And here is our server procedure. Okay, what do we have here in the forms attributes? This object attribute is the agreement we are working with. It has this standard attribute owner, which is actually our company. And the company has this tabular section we need to browse through to find the email. Okay, let's do it. I can type this form and here is my object. Or actually, I can omit this form and call object directly. This is the agreements owner, that is our company, and these are contacts. So I'm cycling through all the contacts like this. And now I can check if the current contact is an email just like this. See how I called the email element as if it was an enumeration value. This is because the item is predefined and the platform knows it exists. This email value will never change and does not go anywhere, so my code will work no matter what. I'm not going to write the actual code for email sending right now. This is another topic for the senior level. This is how we use predefined items in OneC Enterprise. Up next, document posting.